بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from us all. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us for our shortcomings. And let's begin with this huge event and this huge topic that, of course, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a name we've heard from when we were born. And until now, and bi-idhnillah, when we die and when we enter our grave, we're going to be asked, who is our messenger? Who is our prophet? And this, the answer to this question is going to depend on how much you knew of him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this life. So let me first begin by making it clear that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not in need of any one of us at all. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not in need of our defense for our beloved messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at all. Allah azza wa jal is not in need of that. Allah Azza wa Jal has already defended His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and He has already raised the rank of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and He's already given him the highest station in the paradise, which is known as Al-Wasida. So that's all good. Allah Azza wa Jal has said, "Inna kafaynaka al-mustahzi'een," that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sufficient as a protector for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam against everyone who insults him and mocks him and belittles him in any way, shape or form. So that, let's make that very clear. However, we do so in terms of defending the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we must do so in order to prove our iman in Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in order to prove our belief in him. We do so in order to gain Allah's pleasure and to gain Allah azza wa jal's acceptance. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He declared those who defend Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as salihul mu'mineen, as in Surah At-Tahrim. Allah azza wa jal, He says, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ مَوْلَاهُ وَجِبْرِيلُ وَصَالِحُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. So when we defend the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and when we do it strongly with strong words, we're doing it so we can attain and earn the title of salihul mu'mineen, so that we can be from among the righteous believers. That's why we do that. So once again, when we're defending the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when we're going to learn about who Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is, when we want to reintroduce the ummah to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and to teach the entire world about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we know in the back of our minds that this is an act of worship. This is an act of worship. When we do that, we're seeking Allah's reward for every single word we speak in defense of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Let's say first and foremost that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a core element of our faith. I mean, everyone knows, even our children know, that the tenets of Islam are five. Arkan al-Islam, the pillars of Islam, are five. The first of them is Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. There is no Islam without this testimony, and this testimony is made up of two parts. The first part is that you accept Allah as being the only Lord worthy of worship. And then the second part is to accept Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as being the final messenger and prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a core element of our deen. Meaning if this is rejected and refused, your entire Islam is shunned. Your entire Islam is gone. And not only this, when we speak also about arkan al-iman, which are the pillars, and the tenets of iman, of belief, they are six. And one of them is وَتُؤْمِنَ بِاللَّهِ وَمَلَائِكَتِهِ وَكُتُبِهِ وَرُسُلِهِ, that you must accept Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's messenger. So this is what we're speaking about essentially when we're going to speak about who Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is for us. The second thing we find is that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is actually a gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to humanity, to mankind. He's a gift. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Ali Imran, He says, لَقَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذْ بَعَثَ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْ أَنفُسِهِمْ. Allahu Akbar. Allah Azza wa Jal, He described the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as man. Well, man is a gift that you give. Allah Azza wa Jal is saying in the ayah, indeed, certainly, no doubt about it, verily, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has gifted the believers. He gifted them. What did He gift them with? He gifted them with money they have. He gifted them with children. He gifted them with businesses and certificates they have. None of this was relevant. None of this is mentioned. Then what did He gift us with? He gifted us with the greatest gift we'll ever know in our life. And that is the gift that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is our leader, is our messenger that will guide us to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that will guide us to the pleasure of Allah azza wa jal, that will guide us to the highest levels of the paradise. That's essentially the role of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And therefore, this is why he's a gift. لَقَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذْ بَعَثَ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْ أَنفُسِهِمْ. The moment Allah gifted the believers, the moment he sent among them a prophet from them. Allahu Akbar. For this is what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is for us. He's a gift of Allah to us that is going to guide us to the highest levels of the paradise and guide us to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's pleasure. And you know, subhanallah, it is always, always good to be a Muslim. Any time in life and any time in history, it's good to be a Muslim. But the best time to be a Muslim is right now, is when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent to mankind. That is the best time in history to be a Muslim. That you're a Muslim in the nation of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know, there were Muslims in the time of Nuh alayhi salam, Muslims in the time of Zakariya alayhi salam, Muslims in the time of Isa alayhi salam, the time of Musa alayhi salam. But these are all Muslims, and this is all a good time to be a Muslim. But the best time to be a Muslim is to be a Muslim in the nation of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because the nation of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the followers of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, are special. They're special to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that we deserve and we will get Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's shafa'ah on the Day of Judgment, his intercession. And we will be the first ummah to be held accountable and then to enter the paradise. Allahu Akbar. The first ummah to enter the paradise. This is why Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a gift to us that we must appreciate and be grateful for. Also, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah, he asked such an important question. Who is he? Who is he for us? How do the Muslims observe the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Let me clarify this even further. And no place better than the Quran to explain to us who Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is for us. Because at the end of the day, the Quran is the word of Allah. This is Allah telling us who Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is for us. Allah azza wa jalla, he says, النبي أولى بالمؤمنين من أنفسهم وأزواجه أمهاتهم. سبحان الله. Allah Azza wa Jalla, he says that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is closer to the believers than they are to each other. Allahu Akbar. Let me repeat this and understand it. Please understand this. Allah is telling us that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he better be closer to us than we are to each other. He's closer to us than we are to each other. In other words, he's in more entitled to us than we are to our own selves. And this is why in the same ayah, قِرَاءَةَ Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he would say, وَأَزْوَاجُهُ أُمَّهَاتُهُمْ وَهُوَ أَبُوهُمْ وَهُوَ أَبُوَ لَهُمْ. That Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's the father of the believers. He's our father. And his wives are our mothers. This is why Ummat al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was considered ikhwa. We were considered brothers of each other. Why? Because our father is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and our mothers are the wives of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when we say Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is our father, meaning our father in religion, our father in ad-deen. Otherwise, our biological fathers are known. And our first biological father is known, and that is Adam alayhi salam. But Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam being our father, meaning in religion, that means he is closer to each and every single one of us than we are to each other. And you have a relationship with your wife. You have a relationship with your husband. You have a relationship with your children, your sons and your daughters. You have a relationship with your parents. And all these are close relationships. But the relationship that is closest to you is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and what he means to you. That needs to be closer than anything else and any relationship you ever have in life. And so what does that actually mean? That means that we're supposed to give Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam preference in our life. And we need to prioritize Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam before anyone and anything else. Whether he wants our wealth, or he wants our children for his sake. If he wants ourself for his sake, we're supposed to sacrifice it and give it in. And we don't do that for anyone else. other than Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we do that for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. And so, yani, if our nafs, if your nafs was to call you to something, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had called us to something that goes against what ourself wants, we must, it's an obligation to answer his call. This is what is meant by an-nabiyyu awla bil mu'minina min anfusihim, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is more entitled to us than we are to our own selves. He's entitled to us. He tells us what to do and what not to do. You understand? You need to bring this as close as you can in your life. Sunnah al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam must be living in your house. It must be living with you wherever you are, even in your bed. When you sleep, you're sleeping and you're saying adhkar that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught you. And even in the highest form of pleasure in the life of a believer, when a believer is having sexual relations with his wife, even at that moment, you're supposed to remember what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us of the dua to make. Yani, this is in every aspect of your life, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is why Allah Azza wa Jal, he said, وَإِن تُطِيعُوهُ تَهْتَدُوا, that if you were to obey him, then surely you will be guided. Allah Azza wa Jal tied guidance with the obedience of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahu Akbar. You want guidance? You're seeking guidance in your life? وَإِن تُطِيعُوهُ تَهْتَدُوا. That's the prescription. That's the solution. Obey his commands. Allah Azza wa Jal, he says, وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. Obey the messenger, so that perhaps you may attain mercy. And that is the equation. If you want mercy in your life, if you want barakat in your life, if you want Allah to open up closed doors in your life, if you want all this agony and this stress and this discomfort and hardships in your life to be made easy and you're able to manage them, because hardship and difficulty will never go from your life, but if you want them to become more manageable and easier for you to deal with, وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. Then obey the messenger and follow the messenger, and definitely you will earn Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy. Allahu Akbar. For this is what it means. وَهُوَ أَبُوهُمْ, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is our father. He's our father in the deen. You look into the hadith of Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, that is narrated by Imam al-Bukhari wa Muslim, yani highest degree in ahadith, authenticity, highest degree in authenticity in ahadith. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, مَا مِن مُؤْمِنٍ إِلَّا وَأَنَا أَوْلَى بِهِ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. He said, there is not a single believer except that I am more entitled to him. I am more entitled to him than he is entitled to anyone else. Allahu Akbar. Subhanallah. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, yani, we're answering this question, who is he to us? What does he mean to us? And I intend in what I'm answering now and the points I'm giving you, I'm intending in that. I hope that I'm able to inspire you and motivate you and encourage you, that you understand once again who Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is, that you understand the importance of obeying him and following him, and that you understand how he's entitled to you more than you are to your own self. Take this hadith for example. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as I said, he taught us everything. He taught us everything about Allah. He taught us hope in life. He gave us hope in this life and in the hereafter. Wallahi, without Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's teaching, we will not have hope in life. We will not have hope in this life, nor in the hereafter. Look, subhanAllah, there are so many believers that go through a lot of calamities, a lot of tests in life. What gives them hope other than what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught them? Other than what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught them? Otherwise, look. Look at the people that don't follow Rasulullah. Look at the people that have ignored Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Look at the people that have disbelieved in him. How time after time, suicide attacks, depression, anxiety, mental illnesses. I'm not saying that believers aren't, yani Allah Azza wa Jal doesn't test them with that. They may be tested with that. That's definite, no issue. But I'm saying when it happens to people that don't have a religion whatsoever, that's because there's a spiritual void in their life. Something is missing. Something doesn't make sense. As for the believers, they find their comfort in the words of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that were conveyed to us via the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, he says in a hadith, and look at this, يعني, I want to share this hadith with you so you can understand. Does he, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, know about us? Does he really even care about us? I mean, we exist thousands, centuries after him صلى الله عليه وسلم. What did he think about us? Is there any hadith that refers to us living in this time right now? Yes, there is. Wallahi, there are hadith that will put smiles on your face and make you even more engulfed in passion, love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Listen to this hadith. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one day, at al-maqbara, he entered into the cemetery. Al-maqbara, al-baqiyah, he entered into the cemetery in al-Madinah. Faqal, then he said, which is the dua that is supposed to be said when you enter the graveyard. He said, As-salamu alaykum dara qawmin mu'mineen. Peace be upon you, O believers, that have now been laid to rest. He said, Wa inna insha'allahu bikum lahiqoon. He said, by the will of Allah, we're going to be following you very soon. In other words, it's only a couple more days, a couple more years, a couple more months. We're going to die and we're going to follow you as well to the grave. We'll be buried. As he said that, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and I shared the beginning of the hadith so you can understand what he said next. Yani, this is like, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is standing in the graveyard, in the cemetery, and he's remembering death. He's sending his dua upon the dead. He's asking Allah to bestow his mercy upon them. He's remembering death. He knows that he will die. He remembers his ummah that's going to come after him. Who are these people that are going to come after me? So at that moment he said, وَدِدْتُ أَن قَدْ رَأَيْنَا إِخْوَانَنَا. He looked at his companions around him. And he said, my companions, I wish that I had seen my brothers. So they said to him, أَوَلَسْنَا إِخْوَانَكَ. Aren't we your brothers? And he, what are you talking about? Aren't we your brothers? And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Antum ashabi, you're my companions. Ikhwani alladhina lam ya'tu ba'd. My brothers are people that haven't come yet. My brothers are those that will come after me. They will believe in me and they haven't seen me yet. Ya'ani Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam remembered us as he was standing in the graveyard. He remembered, he said to his companions, you're my companions. My true brothers, my real brothers, are those that will come way after me. They have never seen me, but they believe in me. Allahu Akbar. Why? Because this is the highest level. This is the highest level of iman and faith. To believe in him while you haven't seen him. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahu Akbar. Ya'ni wallahi, my brothers and sisters in Islam, I think we should be embarrassed. Look at the love he had for us. Look at the eagerness he had to meet us. And you still have Muslims that don't observe the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they don't see the great importance of the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then you have non-Muslims far worse than that, insulting Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and mocking him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is eager to meet those. And he loves those that are going to come after him. That is you and I, his ummah, that still haven't seen him, yet they will believe in him. Allahu Akbar. And you know, at this very moment, all of us, wallahi, all of us, and I don't have doubt, in true believers, all of us wish to see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in our dream. How many of us wish to see him in our dream? Yet when he was standing with his companions, he's telling them, I wish I saw them in real life. He's not wishing to see us in his dream. He was wishing to see us in real life. And bi-idhnillahi ta'ala, this meeting is going to happen one day. It's just a matter of us dying and then being resurrected. And the meeting with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is going to be at the hawd. At the hawd, in where we're going to come and drink. That water that is in al-hawd, Allahu Akbar, that's where the meeting with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will happen. That's why Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to his companions during his life, اصبروا حتى تلقوني على الحوض. He said, be patient, hold firm unto your deen, be steadfast until we meet at al-hawd, which is a grand event of the events of the Day of Judgment. Subhanallah, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in an authentic hadith narrated by Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu and found in Sahih Muslim, he also, in this hadith, in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam discussed Who from among his nation? Yani, what's a sign of us having love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? What's a sign of us having true love for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Listen to this hadith. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّ مِنْ أَشَدِّ أُمَّتِي حُبًّا لِي نَاسٌ يَكُونُونَ بَعْدِي يَوَدُّ أَحَدُهُمْ لَوْ رَآنِي بِأَهْلِهِ وَمَالِهِ. الله أكبر. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, from among my nation, those who love me the most. This is a challenge to all of us. And النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم is telling us, from among us all, who are the ones that are going to love him the most? He said, they are people that come after me. They wish to see me, even if it costs them their family and their wealth. Allahu Akbar. Do you feel like this? Do you feel like you're able to sacrifice all your wealth and your family and your own self just to see Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Do you feel like this? If you feel like this and you're certain of this feeling in your heart, then that means you should be a follower and a great follower of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because that is a true sign of loving Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Subhanallah, subhanallah. This is why we need to understand, yani, he is the one sallallahu alayhi wa sallam who loved us more than our own selves. Our iman is incomplete, our iman is broken without having this true love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Subhanallah. And you know, you find in the hadith of Abdullah bin Hisham radiyallahu anhu, he says, perhaps I share with you this hadith to understand why do we have to love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than ourselves? Because if you understand why, you begin to work on that. It begins to make sense for you and to you. And as a result, you'll feel more comfortable with this love you're supposed to have for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It'll make sense for you. It'll become logic. Abdullah bin Hisham radiyallahu anhu, he narrates a hadith. He says, كُنَّا مَعَ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. My brothers, my sisters, every time you hear a Nabi, you must say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Say it every time we say his name. So Abdullah bin Hisham, he says, we were with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَهُوَ آخِذٌ بِيَدِ عُمَرْ ابْنِ الْخَطَّابِ. And he was holding the hand of Umar ibn al-Khattab. Such a precious moment. He's holding the hands of Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu. فَقَالَ لَهُ Umar. So Umar radiallahu anhu, he said to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, La anta ahabbu ilayya min kulli shay' illa min nafsi. He said to him, Ya Rasulullah, I love you more than anyone and anything except myself, for I love myself more than you. He's being honest. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu. We learn honesty. You must be honest so that you can get the right answer. So then the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to him, La, no, that's not accepted, Ya Umar. وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ حَتَّى أَكُونَ أَحَبَّ إِلَيْكَ مِن نَفْسِكَ. He said to him, no, you haven't attained complete iman, the highest level of iman, until you love me more than you love your own self. So Umar radiallahu anhu went for a while and he came back. And then he said, فَإِنَّهُ الْآنْ أَنْتَ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِن نَفْسِي. He said, right now, Ya Rasulullah, wallahi, I swear to it. Yani, he's saying, Ya Rasulullah, wallahi, trust me, believe me, I'm not lying this time. La anta ahabbu ilayya min nafsi. I swear by Allah, you are more beloved to me than my own self. I love you more than I love myself. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Al-ana ya Umar. Now, Ya Umar, you have attained a high level of iman. But the point is this, in Umar radiallahu anhu, what made him change his mind in a matter of seconds? I mean, just a moment ago, he said that he loved himself more than Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And moments later, he's saying, wallahi, I love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than I love myself. What happened? How did he change his mind in a matter of moments? You see, the thing is this, Umar radiallahu anhu realized, how will I be saved from the punishment of Allah without the guidance of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Umar radiallahu anhu realized, how will I enter the paradise without the guidance of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? How will I attain the love of Allah azza wa jal and the acceptance of Allah without Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? If it wasn't for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam,
we would have all been worshipping idols. We would have been worshipping animals and insects and trees and rocks and stones and so on. We would have lost it. We would have lost the plot. We would have suffered our entire life. In this life and in the hereafter, it's double trouble. فَعُمَرْ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ quickly realized that he must love the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than himself. Allahu Akbar. And this is why. In our salawat, every single salat we pray, we are sending peace and blessings upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When we say in our tashahud, As-salamu alayka ayyuhan nabi wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Allahu Akbar. فَيَعْنِي سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ. This is the kind of love we're supposed to have for him. This is who and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is for us. This is what I've been sharing for the last half an hour. Who Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is for us.